Welcome to HHT TV News. I'm Mrs. Alguacet, your principal.
I'm Mr. Hutchison, your assistant principal.
Good morning to pre-K.
Good morning, kindergarten.
Good morning, first grade.
Good morning, second grade.
Good morning, third grade.
Good morning, fourth grade.
Good morning, fifth grade.
Good morning, staff.
And good morning, parents. We are so glad to be coming into your homes on this beautiful Monday morning. Yes. Today is Monday, March the 30th, 2020. We are on week two of being home. We still miss you just as much as we did last week, and it feels like it's been forever since we've seen you. But we are glad to see you and be interacting with you on Class Dojo and on Facebook. Thank you for sharing all of your pictures last week. It was so much fun to see your faces.
Yes, wasn't it? It was great. It's kind of chilly out there this morning.
Okay.
Yes. Yes, it's like 40. It's right now, it's 49 degrees there. It's cold.
It is. It is cold.
Feels like 45, it says. It's supposed to be a high of 69 today. The low is 42, so we're already past the low. So today might be a pretty good day to maybe stay inside to do some learning.
Yes, we have some learning opportunities available for all of you at home, boys and girls, actually. So that call out went out this morning. There was also a text message that went out to your parents. And so what Mr. Hutchison and I wanted to do this morning is walk parents, you through the steps on exactly how to get there. We know that your teachers are going to be sending you distance learning choice boards directly on Class Dojo. If you are not connected to Class Dojo and you have a question about being connected to Class Dojo, I'm going to share my email with you on our Facebook post so that you can let me know if you have not yet been connected. That's what our teachers are, their goal is this week, to ensure that everyone's connected so that they can help you answer any questions that you might have about the distance learning opportunities presented to you this week.
Yes, I'm going to go ahead and share the screen. That way you can see the website here. So I'm going to go ahead and go to the Plainview ISD. Here's the Plainview ISD website. So what you'll do here is, once you reach the home page here, you'll just need to scroll down past the events. And over here on the left side of the screen is the COVID-19 online instructional learning. And if you'll just click that link right there, it will take you somewhere there. And Ms. Alcazar is going to kind of go over some instructions here.
Okay, so all of the information regarding meals, instruction, any statements from our superintendent, Dr. Sanchez, and also the emergency board meeting, they are listed as resources or links on this page. So what we want to draw your attention to today is the link that says elementary distance learning. You'll notice that there is secondary distance learning as well, and exceptional distance learning too. Yes, so, Mr. Hutch, if you'll click on elementary as well. Yes, mental health resources are available there, too.
All right. So here we go.
Okay. So each of these, behind each of these grade levels, are multiple resources. So let's just shoot for the middle, Mr. Hutch. And why don't you click on third grade?
Third grade. There's third grade.
So third grade takes you to a recommended schedule, and then it has a lot of resources. So it has, if you'll click on the recommended schedule, and we'll also post this in a separate graphic on our Facebook page, this is the schedule that we are recommending to you this week. So you'll notice there are no times tied to it. And I want to point you to the two boxes that say academics. There's actually a morning academic time and an afternoon academic time. So in the morning, your direction is to select one reading, math, and writing option from your choice board. And again, those will be sent to you directly on Class Dojo, and you also can find them back on this website. In the afternoon, you would select one science or social studies activity from your choice board as well. In the middle, you have your regular routines. You have free time, lunch, and quiet time. And on either side of that, you would have your family routine, and also for the morning and also for the evening. So If you'll pop back to the page before, Mr. Hutch. Okay, so let's click on third grade, March 30th, distance learning choice board.
Okay. There's a Spanish version there too, just so we know.
Yes. So all of these are color-coded. So you'll see the math is yellow. There's an activity for a section for each day of the week. Then there is writing in green. There's reading in blue, science in purple, social studies in orange. So you'll be able to see that for every grade level, there are some high-tech or low-tech options where you may need a device or where you might not need a device to complete all of these activities. Again, your teachers would be available for any questions that you have regarding any of the learning that is listed on these choice boards.
Right. Looks like they have a link here for Imagine Learning, too.
Yes, lots of hyperlinks are also embedded into not only the choice boards, but also onto each grade level page. So be sure to look over it. And again, let us know what questions you have.
All right. Anything else you want to look at on this page?
I think we're good.
All right. Okay. So let me go back here and all right. There we go.
Okay, thank you for walking us through that, Mr. Hutchison. We wanted to give you a quick preview or a look as you start to dive into those choice boards this morning on our week two that we're heading into. And of course, this is the district remote learning plan that was rolled out to us by our district leader. So lots of thanks to Mrs. Garrett and her team. And these are people that you probably don't even know, but you just need to know that they're working very, very hard for you.
Yeah.
And we at the campus level are very appreciative. So again, we're going to be sharing with you all of these resources across all of our platforms so that you have access any direction you choose. ClassDojo, Facebook, we'll put some hyperlinks in this YouTube video as well. So thank you for being our partners in learning this week as we move forward with our choice boards. I'm really excited for you to see them and carry out some of those activities on there.
Yes, it's going to be fun. I think it looks pretty fun. Going to be
I'm really excited.
I'm still missing the students though. Still missing you guys.
Very true. There's nothing that can replace those boys and girls in our hallways and in our classrooms. And so just remember, we do miss you and we love you tremendously.
Yes. Did you do an instrument, Miss Alcazar?
You know, I kind of fiddled around with one, but Mr. Hutchison, I don't think that it came out quite like yours.
Well, mine is over there, so I will shoot a short video and put that at the end. That way they can kind of see the different things that I did with that, because I know Miss Sel said that she wanted to see it, so, but I'm afraid she might be having me build instruments if I show her.
We've discovered another talent. So yes, you may be busy building instruments.
Yes, probably. But there's different things you can do with these. So that's pretty cool.
Awesome. Well, we look forward to seeing that. And don't forget that right after we've signed off of announcements, Mr. Hutchison is going to share that information or that video with us. So that'll be fun to see. Stay tuned.
Yes. Yes. And any other challenge that the teachers have, hopefully we'll get placed on here as well in the next day or two. Hopefully. I'm looking forward for some math challenges.
Lots of math challenges on our choice boards. Absolutely. Yes. So they can absolutely dig into the math there first, and then we will move forward.
Yes. We've seen I had a lot of challenges last week with Ms. Huffines and her, the scavenger hunts. Hopefully, did you do any of the scavenger hunts?
We did. We did some indoor and some outdoor hunts. So that was fun. We had, of course, there's always a reminder, boys and girls, that anything that you are doing or taking care of that you clean up afterwards. So there's always a two-step process. You can get busy and have fun, but then right behind that, make sure you're cleaning up maybe any of the materials that you used while you were using them. Another reminder, as we maybe start this daily learning piece, it doesn't always mean that you have have to be on a device or a gadget. So, but do remember that at the end of the day to recharge, maybe it's a phone you're using, a tablet, an iPad, a laptop, a computer. So make sure that those are plugged in and charged, ready for you for the next morning.
Yes, yes. That's awesome.
All right, Mr. Hedge, I think that's all I have today.
That's all I have today too, except for the video at the end. And go ahead. I'm Mr. Hutchison, your assistant principal.
And I'm Mrs. Alcosed, your principal, reminding you too, and say it with us. Do it the Highland way. Be successful every day. Have a great day.
Have a great Monday, guys.
Good morning. I just wanted to show you my instrument this morning. I'm not finished with it quite, but you'll get the idea what I'm working on. Okay, here is my instruments. Remember, I was cutting a pipe the other day. And so these are aluminum pipes that I, or sticks of aluminum that I cut out of old lawn chairs. So basically, I just cut them at different lengths. And you'll see I have holes drilled in the top, and I'll show you why that is here in a few minutes. But I have them laying on some cork bed from my train sets that I have. So basically, if you can kind of tell me what this is, and they're each a different length. I'm just using a regular pencil here. There you go. So there's my instrument. Here's my dog. One of my dogs. But do you see this wind chime? That's what the end result will be eventually.